Good morning, everybody. CrazyJuan back at you on the Xbox One. Doing a little Elgato game capture. I'm going to continue my path through the NASCAR expansion for Forza Motorsport 6. Been really enjoying recording these races. Ran with no assists and no rewind with the help of getting them on YouTube with my buddy Mike over at Original Next Level Gaming. Be sure to swim past the YouTube page. Well, you'd be watching this there, so I guess that makes sense. But anyway, since you're here, go ahead and give it a like and a subscription. It's got a lot of good stuff. Does a really nice podcast every Friday. Sans the fanboy nonsense. Good chat room to be in, too.
Your next stops are at Europe's biggest endurance racing circuits. Some nearly 100 years old and brimming with history.
Good old Hockenheimring. I kind of have a love-hate for this track. Kind of love it.
Will be at Hockenheim, featuring very slight elevation changes.
Kind of hate it. So we were at Daytona last, which is a...
Every car shares the same greenhouse area. Every manufacturer's body style reflects their production vehicle, with only slight aerodynamic differences between cars.
So yeah, we were at Daytona last, so we're going to change the setup just a little bit. Primarily going to shorten up that gearing so we get a little more acceleration. Take a little more advantage of the added power mod I have. Also, we're going to jack up the downforce to help out in the corners. It's probably too much. We're probably scrubbing some speed there that we don't really need to, but it's worked thus far. Gotta put a mod on or waste the spot. So let's do perfect turns. Not that I don't have enough money, I have 44 million and a half, and I'll never spend all of it. I mean, I could, I suppose, pretty easy, just running through and buying stuff, but I don't usually buy cars until I'm using them. And we're off. Well, it could have gone worse. It could have gone better, but... Big braking zone here. This upcoming kink to the right, AI tends to underdo it a little bit. It wasn't too bad of them. Didn't have quite the run I was looking for. Five laps. Can't waste too much time behind number 8 here. Should be able to get him inside here. Ooh, cooked it. Too much. Hang on. Damn. A hot mess this morning. Alright, we got some work to do. Thought about looking inside on number 8 there, but on the 8th place car, but it was a little too tight. Outside on 7 here. Alright, that went better. A little better throttle control that lap. Good news is, first really didn't run away from the pack, so got a shot here. Yikes, out of shape. That could have gone better. That too. that three. Leader ran wide. Let's make some ground here, maybe. Yep, I'll take it. Well, did this one on one take, if I don't screw it up between here and the finish. Well, that's kind of fun. And that's the Hockenheimring. Well, without a lot of major contact, I was pretty happy with that run. I'm gonna guess 250. Nope. Used to be pretty good at guessing those. Next is the Nurburgring GP.
Racing in the rain is challenge enough, but to compete against GT race cars and win on a wet Nurburgring circuit is on a whole new level.
Yeah, that might be a bite.
For the next race, you can drive your current car or the number 20 Joe Gibbs Racing Toyota Camry.
I don't want to.
Driven in NASCAR by 2003 series champion Matt Kenseth.
Can't make me.
Your next race will be at the Nurburgring, home of the 24 hours of Nurburgring.
Probably the GP circuit. Don't imagine it's the ring. This is where not having traction control is gonna bite me. Let's go ahead and grab some grid position. This turn is going to be ugly as sin. Could have been worse, I guess. Cars are everywhere, though. I'm going to take that and run, I think. Trying for perfect clean through that would be many, many restarts, I think. Ooh, puddle. Also, I think having the grid position is a big help there. Because it's still a disaster behind me. Man, hard to get a good launch out of this. First, starting to walk away. Tough braking area here, because it kind of sneaks up on you. Oh, Nelly, come on. It's not great for speed, but when you need traction, you can upshift, like from second to third, for example. Cut back on the wheel spin a little bit. Then if you're not running with any traction control. Also, if you're not running ABS, downshifting is a good way to apply some engine braking to help with slowing the car without locking up the wheels. You just have to do it at an RPM that it won't damage the engine. Oh man, it's gonna be hard to catch this guy, I think. That puddle on the inside there is mean. Hot. Damn. Just want a little bit of bite out of the corner. It's eating up all my power and acceleration advantage when it goes to wheel spin. Maybe third is the key. Yeah, he's killing me off the corner. Puddle, ah. Ugh. side, maybe. Got him. Light, traction, the car's yelling back at me, throttle control. Better. Kind of babied that just a little bit, because it'd be a real shame to screw it up this far into it. But yeah, I'm pretty happy with that. It's going to be a minimal contact, one take rate win in the rain. Yeah, I'll take that. Spa is the next course, and I like Spa. Yeah, that's to be expected. I don't think all those times are necessarily in the wet. A lot of times I'll do.
The next race will be at the Circuit de Spa Francorchamps, located in the Ardennes Forest.
A lot of times I'll do two races and then three in the series, but these are going well enough. I might as well try to share the three. Only got 27 minutes or so into the recording so far.
know, I think a modern cup car on spa would be fun. I think it would be pretty challenging to run it around there. You know, the lack of grip and the way that turn goes, it'd be pretty out of control. You'd be sliding around pretty good, but I think it would get your attention for sure.
Don't hit that driver level boost this time. First corner here can be a mess sometimes too. Big hairpin after, you know, some acceleration. Let's shoot the gap. Yes, not bad. Should have downshifted. But not a bad start. We'll take it and run. Stay wide here because I got one inside me, or to my inside, I don't know, right? Mike, you can feel free to edit that one out, but nice run off that corner. Gravitar overreaction that he's going to be wide. He could have held his line, but the game makes the Gravitar, if you get close enough, they'll just dive away from you. It's something you can actually exploit to make passes. Shape there, but not too bad. Up to sixth. Blew the breaking point there a little bit. Driving to stationary objects is dumb. Forgot that cuts over. Ah, grass slows you down. Third place cooked it a little bit. Ah, come on, get off me. Well, that was better than the first lap anyway. Might not have any traffic holding me up in the famous Al Rouge corner here. Driver tried trying to slam the door on me. I did that hairpin a lot better than that Drivatar did. Late on my turn in. Oh well. Looks like I'm on a bit of a roll today. Three races and no restarts. Thank you. going to Silverstone next, maybe? Yep, in the rain. Alrighty, well, I think that is going to be enough for today. I gotta spend a little time before I go to work today doing some other stuff, but thanks for anyone who catches this video on the original Next Level Gaming YouTube channel. Be sure to like and subscribe. I've got my own YouTube channel, CrazyJuan, on YouTube. Also, you can follow me on Xbox Live and on Twitter as CrazyJuan. Feel free to leave any comments, feedback, anything like that. Or, you know, like I said, follow me on those places. I'll follow you back. Thanks again. Hope everyone has a great weekend. No, it's only Thursday, isn't it? Well, have a great rest of your weekend.